What's up, Savannah State? It's your girl, Adeline Amelia.
And it's your boy, D-Lo. And I know y'all enjoyed the first episode.
So we're back with another episode.
So stay tuned.
It's going up. On Sunday, January 26th, we received news of the tragic deaths of Kobe Bryant and eight other victims involved in the fatal helicopter crash. Among those victims was his daughter, Gianna Bryant. The Juice Live sends condolences to all families involved in the incident.
Now let's take a moment of silence.
On Saturday, the boys went into double overtime against Benedict College and came out with the W.
With that being said, our girls and boys both scored 81 points in remembrance of Kobe Bryant. Congratulations on our win against Payne College, and we're looking forward to next week against Albany. Now we pass it on to Q for Fashion Night.
So it wasn't just a regular game, it was actually Fashion Night, and the campus really stepped out. The Sauce Cam went crazy, and Savage Incorporated also put on a dope halftime performance. It really felt like old FSU, so we encourage everyone to continue to express themselves creatively through fashion.
Slam now, we got the real jam going down. Welcome to the Space Jam. Space Jam. Here's your chance, do your dance at the Space Jam. Alright.
In the workplace. Even I was a victim of having to get asked to take out my actual dreadlocks simply because they were seen inappropriate for work.
That's true, man. We went around Savannah State University today to ask students on how they felt about the statement of the injustice of what's happening to the African-American students. Let's take a look on the man on the street.
What's going on? It's your boy, Kevante Kelly. That's right, Famous K, coming from The Juice Live. And we are here on The Man on the Street, okay? So I have a pretty sensitive topic here, but it's very important to talk about, okay? So there's a student that's actually over there in Texas right now who's getting denied his privilege to walk across the stage at his graduation simply because of the texture and the style of his hair, which are dreadlocks. So coming from African-American to African-American, I'm just asking y'all, what are your opinion on that?
I believe it's very discriminatory and it's racist, but not racist because your hair should have nothing to do with your education. I mean, if you're smart, you're smart.
Yes.
Let the man graduate.
Me personally, I have very coarse hair, so I would, you know, feel take it personal if someone told me I couldn't do something because of my hair.
Correct. I do believe also that your hair does not discriminate against your actual abilities and your gifts and your talents. So that's a great statement that you guys made as well. You guys have caught it here first at the Juice Live. Stay tuned. We're going to be asking some more things about this actual very sensitive topic, okay?
What's going on, everybody? It's your boy Malachi Stewart, the hottest host coming out of the Juice Live, and I am here with
Q.
Y'all already know, Mr. Q, thank you for your time. I'm gonna be quick and short. There is a statement, well, a problem going on in Texas. There's a student named DeAndre Arnold, a young African-American teen, and he was suspended at his school. Now he won't be able to graduate because of his dread. Can you just tell us and tell me how you feel about that situation?
Well, I feel as though it's unfair to him because if it was a male of a different race, I feel like they would allow him to still graduate if they had long hair.
Definitely.
So I feel like it's some racial issues going on.
Most definitely. I agree with you 100%, guys. Well, you heard it here first. Make sure you follow The Juice Live at Instagram, man. Again, my name is Malachi.
Q.
And we'll see you later. What's going on, everybody? My name is Malachi Stewart, the hottest host coming out of Juice Live, and I'm here with Mr. Junior himself.
Yes, sir.
Mr. Tyler Hodges. I'm not gonna take up too much of your time, but I just wanted to share a topic with you guys as well. There's a young teen named DeAndre Arnold. He goes to school in Texas, and he has dreads, and his school suspended him just because he won't cut his dreads. Now he won't be able to graduate. And I just wanted to ask you, how do you feel about that? A young teen, a young African-American, not able to graduate because of his hair.
I feel as if this is very intolerable. Like, for as an African American in today's society, it's already hard enough as it is to be a successful person, and hindering somebody to graduate simply because of their hair is unacceptable. It's totally unacceptable, and there needs to be a change immediately. But shouts out to this young man, and I hope that he gets his degree and become a successful black man in today's society.
Exactly, y'all heard it here first. And to me, it's really unacceptable.
What's going on? It's your boy Famous K coming fresh out of the Juice Live, and we are here again with another man on the street. All right, my boys, so I got a pressing issue that's happening over in Texas right now, okay? So it's a student, like ourselves, African-American, he's ready to graduate, and he's getting denied his access to walk across the stage simply because of the demeanor of his hair. It's your dreadlocks. What is your view on that? How do you feel?
You wanna go first? So for me, It get a little bit personal.
Right.
Because, like, I got family who's Jamaican, and they got that Rastafarian.
Rastafarian, correct.
And you
correct.
Know, your hair is a symbol of wisdom and strength.
Correct.
And, like, just
commitment.
Overcome. Yeah, over everything, basically. Your hair is everything in the Rastafarian belief. So, like, them trying to force him to cut his head, it go against everything I stand for, because how can you tell me not to do what symbolize me?
Exactly.
Symbolize my people.
Taking everything away from me, basically.
Yeah.
I completely get what you're
saying. I fully agree on that. And also, I read on that, and his family is Caribbean, something like that.
Really?
So it was like you said, for strength and all that. So it was like, why now you want him to cut his dreads? He's been going to school, what, 4 years?
Exactly.
And now you want
all of the requirements to graduate, and simply because of his hair,
Let
my people go. Let my people graduate. Let my people graduate. Is the name. Hey. That's what we're trying to get.
We don't need nothing
right
hindering us.
At all, including our hair. So why did our hair hinder us from our talents, man? You heard it here first at the Juice Live.
Y'all, it's your girl Shelby. Play Too Much. Freestyle Friday was crazy. We had live music, we had live artists, and we had an amazing turnout. Tell them about the time, right?
Man, we had a female artist. Did you see her?
Man, they call me Nia, you can hold the small ball till we fall, had them eating and all. Call me JC, it's only take one call.
Yeah. Boys, with some content, make sure you come out each and every Friday in the student union, starting at 3 p.m.
That wraps up this episode. Y'all seen us at the Frank Keller Boys and Girls Club, and y'all even seen us do some men on the streets.
We even took you guys with us to Freestyle Friday, and y'all came along with us to Fashion Night, and the Tigers brought home a victory.
Y'all follow us on Instagram at TheJuiceLive.
And Twitter at TheJuiceLive_. Stay tuned for all our daily posts every day.
Who got the juice?
Savannah!